It's the NFL on EA Sports, where we'll see a brawl inside the NFC South. It's the Carolina Panthers and the New Orleans Saints, and it's coming up next.
The first open back in 1975. There's a look inside the iconic Caesars Superdome in downtown New Orleans. Today we've got an NFC South matchup, as it'll be the Carolina Panthers taking on the New Orleans Saints. Brandon Gaudin joined by Charles Davis here at the Superdome. But Charles, these Saints, after a good run from 2017 to 2020, kind of been middle of the pack the last couple of years, 7-10 a season ago. What's their recipe for turning things around?
I think continuing the short passing game that they're known for, and see if some of their playmakers can make some short passes into longer plays. And then on defense, continuing to pressure quarterbacks in the pocket. They tend to get after them pretty hard.
Meanwhile, optimism reigning with the visiting Panthers. They've got a new coach. They've got a new quarterback. And they've got a real chance to be a playoff team in 2023.
And a lot of it starts on the defensive side of the ball, where they've been good for the last few seasons. If the offense joins them, they will be a tough out in the NFC South.
So here come the Saints to take over for the first time. And here's the new man under center after 9 seasons as a Raider. Derek Carr is the guy.
It's going to take some time to adjust to seeing Carr running out in a new uniform instead of black and silver. It's black and gold. 35,000 yards and over 200 touchdowns with the Raiders. The Saints more than willing to let him air it out all game long to a talented group of pass catchers in the Big Easy.
In his 7th season now, here's Alvin Kamara. And this will line up a Saints first down as he gets it up past the 35.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. On play action, now Carr. He's got a man, it's his fullback. Same exact result as last play, a pickup of 11.
Good, sure hands there from a guy not accustomed to catching a whole lot of passes. But how about the way he was able to pull that one in and pick up good yardage?
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, 3 plays? 3 first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they'll get to that end zone real fast.
So from Panther territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 34. They run it again with Kamara. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. Carr. There's a short one to the tight end, Johnson. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. Pretty solid opening drive here, Charles. They've worked in the run game, the pass game, just steadily getting yards, and now they've got it inside the red zone here with an opportunity.
And the only thing they don't have so far is points. But the way that they're moving the ball now, that shouldn't take much longer. And they've established a great balance so far, running, passing, doing what they want on offense.
Now Carr. And he's got it. Got his man on the end round. Complete. And the Saints are looking at 1st and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical. They've been crisp. And as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early 1st and goal.
Kamara is not going anywhere. He'll be hit and dropped for no gain at the 2-yard line. We're scoreless after 1.
Ready for the second quarter from New Orleans. It's the Saints in possession as they come up now second and goal. Throwing now is Carr. Looking for Thomas. He's got him. Touchdown, New Orleans. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Saints post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Well, that drive felt like it took up an eternity. We finally have some action on the scoreboard.
Yeah, but plenty of action prior to, because that drive took up all the first quarter before we spilled into the second, and finally, points were registered.
On the other sideline, they're chomping at the bit just to get the football. Will Lutz on for the point after. And it's good as the Saints have a 7-0 lead. So a nice drive put together there. They go 75 yards in 9 plays. And it's Michael Thomas who ends it with a touchdown reception. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback.
So here are the Panthers set to take over for the first time, and Charles will get a look at the much-heralded rookie Bryce Young, the first overall pick from April's draft.
And his task in this situation is making sure this team knows that there's a sense of urgency, yet somehow still stays calm. Because your natural impulse, your first possession is not until the second quarter, is you got to attack right away, throw something big at them right away. Yeah, you've got to move the ball, but maybe be a little bit careful in doing so.
And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
Brandon, to me, what's important right here on this drive is for them to get at least 2 first downs. They've got to give their defense a chance to settle down, catch their breath a little bit.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down.
Young on third down. And that will be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield or man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays just like that one we saw there.
Carolina punt team out there led by Johnny Hecker.
Call it an even 40-yard punt, 7-0 on the return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10.
Derek Carr back out for his guy's next possession. He was 4-for-4 on that opening drive, including the touchdown pass, as he'll try again here to duplicate that success, starting with a first down.
Now a play fake. Carr. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack.
Kamu Crugier-Hill getting in there and taking him down.
Partner, the Mike linebacker, the middle linebacker, has so many different responsibilities. How excited do you think he was to get home with that blitz?
Yeah, he wants a sack. He got it. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. To throw, it's Carr. Being chased out left. The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. Here's Carr to throw. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
And he'll get it down here to the 43. We'll get a pause here. There appears to be a Panther who was shaken up on that last play. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment.
Carr to throw on second down. Looking here for Smith downfield. And this is caught inside the five. A big-time play there for New Orleans. And even 40 yards.
That's just flat out a beautiful throw right there.
It was a rope. That's maybe the speed you would see on a slant, but he threw that downfield with that kind of pace.
Now, if he throws that one with any type of arc, puts a little air under it, that play doesn't happen. He had to fire it in there, and he did exactly that.
Right now. After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal. Now Carr. Down and open, it's Thomas. It's a touchdown for New Orleans. Michael Thomas. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Saints will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Lutzel looked to add the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. So the drive there took six plays. And it's Michael Thomas who ends it with a touchdown reception. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. The Panthers going to go back on offense here late in this first half. Well, not much time remains here in this first half. We'll see if they can get something out of this drive, at least a field goal. They could certainly use it down by two scores. The first down throw for Young. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
I think that's a big-time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he was able to bat it away.
A second down throw for Young. Open receiver, that's Hayden Hurst, the tight end. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. It's Young on first down. Again, that's Hurst. This duo locked in 14 yards there and a first down. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. Young looks to throw on first down. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and have them staring at a third and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
That throw by Young, incomplete. So he's 3-for-7 throwing the football right now. Not an awful start, but also not the sharpest of starts.
No, I would agree with that. But if you're a confident quarterback and to play that position you have to be, you just act like there's something wrong with the wind currents or something wrong with the ball. It is not you. Keep throwing. That timing usually develops.
And Young's throw there incomplete.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw break out on third down? Dime defense. Blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. And this punt sails over the sideline. And the spot, it looks to be right at the 25-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down.
So we have come to halftime in what's already a 2-touchdown game. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit. But first, we welcome everyone to our EA Sports halftime report.
The highlights are fairly one-sided to this point. It's a 2-touchdown difference here at the break. But I wouldn't call this one over just yet. I think there could still be some fireworks yet to come.
Both teams going through their final halftime adjustments. We're about ready to get back to football. And to bring you the second half from the Superdome, let's go back to Brandon and Charles.
All right, Coach, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. A 2-touchdown game, 14-0 to score as we get rolling again here in this second half. And we will not have a run back here as the second half starts with a touchback. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well, and they've kept them around in this game. Now, they got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
On first and 10, Young. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Connection made with Chanel. And he gets this only to the 41. Not near enough for the first. Just a gain of a couple there. And that'll bring up fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Fielded at the 20. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt.
And they will take over first and 10.
Now the attention turns to the Saints offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half.
Carr going to lead the Saints up here first and 10
at their own 27. He'll start with a give to Kamara. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't.
The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down.
Jeremy Chinn, so dangerous wherever he's at on the field. And that time he gets in there for the sack. I'm sure a lot of time was spent in the locker room, Charles, talking with his defense about setting a tone here in the third quarter when you're down on the scoreboard. A sack like that, maybe that can get them going.
Yeah, you have to believe exactly what you just said, and they got together and said, let's be some change agents here. Let's go ahead and turn things around. Let's be the force that gets us going here in the second half and puts us in a position to find a way to win the game. And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 43. Carr gonna throw.
Goes right back to Smith again.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
From the 35, here's second and two.
A give to Kamara running right. And he'll go down at the 28. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
On first down, Carr. And the catch made by Johnson. The Saints passing game in sync and moving the football. It's a first down. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it. They got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
He was brought down by Kamu Grugier-Hill. This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. To throw his car. Eluding the pressure right. And inside the five here before he's out of bounds right at the three. Carr can beat you in a lot of ways. The scramble there, a perfect example as he gets the first.
Well, that's a nice job right there. He's looking downfield, but with no one open, he takes off and tries to run for it. He gets to the sidelines and gets out of bounds with a first down.
Try to pound it in, Kamara. And he will make his way back to where he started from, and that's all, as we will make our way to the two-minute warning.
Now a timeout here, at least for the moment. Looks like one of the Saints is injured, shaken up on that last play. The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside.
They'll go again from the three here on second and goal. Now they'll throw with Carr, rolling to his left. Going to go down just outside of the five, right around the 6 yard line. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Carr now to throw. Hard throw, incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up, not that time. Will Lutz now to try the New Orleans field goal. This to make it a three-score game late. The kick by Lutz is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So with that, you figure, this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from three scores down, but don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though?
And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25.
And the Panthers coming out now.
Well, it's been a struggle so far for this offense, Charles. It's not only that they haven't been able to put the points up, but really stringing yards together has been a real issue for them in this one.
I'm so glad you brought up the yardage because I was thinking to myself, we've seen a lot of NFL games, and we've seen our share of lopsided contests, but in almost all of them, both offenses have put up at least 200 yards in a game, but not in this one. This has been a display of offense that, frankly, I think the two of us have watched from behind our hands, trying to spread our fingers wide enough to actually see the result.
Well, these guys are not going to go out with their tails between their legs. They're going to keep taking their shots until the clock's at triple zeros. But that one, like a lot of others, winds up incomplete.
That throw by Young, incomplete. Well, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
Now a first down throw for Young. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down. Young's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Looks like they're going to keep throwing to the bitter end. This one's long since over, but give them credit. They're going to go down fighting. That one, incomplete.
It'll be Young again. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby. And he returns it into enemy territory, down to the 45-yard line. Third and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him. And what I mean by that is what you said. Third and long, got to push it downfield to try and pick up the first down. Defensive backs live for this situation. And they took advantage of the young man right there.
And now the Saints get set to trot out there. Now they are really in the driver's seat here, enjoying this lead late in the fourth quarter. The defense does have all three timeouts, but at this point, doesn't look like it's going to matter much. They'll pound it up the middle with Kamara. And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. 81 yards rushing now for Kamara. It's a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. Again, it's Kamara. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Now we'll get whistles, and they signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. Kamara up the middle, and he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. So this one, a victory here for New Orleans, and they did it in shutout fashion. Impressive.
Would it be too bland of a statement to say they didn't have the greatest day offensively? I mean,
Did enough, but yeah, you're right.
Most games, it wouldn't have been enough. So they've got to go into the locker room and applaud their defensive mates and say, guys, you really carried us today. We'll try and get you back next time. But as for today, you guys were nails out there.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL.